as a father. You are a provider. Father simply means source. 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 Somebody say source. Now, if father means source, it means that everything that the woman will ever have must come from the man. Until a man releases a seed, a woman cannot conceive. The man is the source of provision in the house. The man is the source of security and protection in the house. Hallelujah. Proverbs 20, the verse number 7. Proverbs 20, the verse number 7. If you are there, you say amen. Amen. And I read, the just man walketh in his integrity, and his children are blessed after him. Yeah. Hallelujah. I want you to look at somebody and tell the person, let men be men. Tell the other person, let men be men. Please, you may be seated in the heavenly places. Choir, thank you. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, I pray in the name of Jesus. Let the entrance of your word bring light. Let it bring illumination. Let it bring understanding to the simple. Father, I pray, O God, that you will speak and minister through me. Father, let your word be potent and have effect, but yet let it come simple. I declare, O God, that we will live here knowing that we have heard your voice and you have spoken to us. In Jesus' name, amen. You know, today being special occasion for all fathers, I decided to preach this message. Hallelujah. Amen. It will gear towards men, but I believe that the women also can learn something out of it. Hallelujah. Amen. I want to wish all fathers this morning a happy, happy Father's Day. Hallelujah. You know, oftentimes, Mother's Day is more celebrated than Father's Day. Hallelujah. That is just the fact, and that is just the truth. But I wonder why Mother's Day is more celebrated than Father's Day, because it is not easy to be a father. And today I will try to enlighten or highlight some responsibilities as a father. And so I believe beyond every reasonable doubt that it's about time that they celebrate the fathers as they celebrate the mothers. Yeah. Hallelujah. Because it is not easy to be a father. And you will understand by the time we are through with this journey. Hallelujah. The Bible says that after God has created the heavens and the earth and has created a garden, he needed somebody to be a caretaker of the garden. And the Bible says that then God created Adam to take care of the garden and to name all the animals. Now, when Adam was naming all the animals, Adam realized that all the animals were in pair. And he realized that he was the only one that was single. Now, don't forget, in the creatorial process, everything that God created, the Bible says God looked at it and he said, it is good. But after Adam had named all the animals and realized that all the animals are in pair, male and female, and he realized that he was all by himself, he asked God a question: how come that I'm all by myself? How come? Everything in the garden is in pairs, but when it comes to me, I am all by myself. And for the very first time in the creatorial process, heaven realized that they have done something that wasn't good. And that is why the Bible says it is not good for a man to be alone. Now, when it happened like that, the Bible says that, and God put Adam to sleep. And when he put Adam to sleep, God removed Eve, or a woman, out of his ribs. I want you to understand, under the sound of my voice, that the first birth wasn't from the womb of a woman. The first birth was from the womb of a man. Because when God created Adam, he created Adam with the clay and breathed into Adam's nostrils, and Adam became a living being. But when it came to woman, God never went back to the clay. God created Adam with the clay and breathed into his nostrils, and Adam became a living being. But when it came to the woman, God never went back to the clay to create a woman, but he removed a woman out of the man. That should tell you that men are loaded. Don't worry, I will break down some things for you. I will work this thing this morning. That should tell you that men are loaded. Now, it also tells us from the scriptures that it is impossible for a man to live alone. A man always needs a companion, somebody he can talk to, somebody that he can relate to, somebody that he can pour out to his intimate feelings. You can have a best friend, but it is not everything you can tell your best friend. There are some things that are very private. There are some things that comes from the depthness of your soul and of your spirit, and you can only tell somebody who you have an affection for. So the Bible says that when Adam waked up, he saw Eve. Now, if the Bible says that when Adam waked up, he saw Eve and said, he is a flesh of my flesh and the bone of my bone, it means that when Adam waked up, Eve wasn't sleeping. Eve was standing, looking at Adam. When Adam waked up, he saw something that he had never seen before. He has seen all the animals, the plants. He has seen all the fishes. He has seen everything that was in the garden, but this particular species, he had never seen it before. And don't forget, none of the animals move Adam into oratory like when he saw the woman. Men who don't even talk, when they see women, they begin to talk. Your diction explodes. Your vocabulary increases. Because there is something about women that triggers the best part of us. So when Adam saw Eve, he said, "This is the bone of my bone and the flesh of my flesh. He shall be called woman." Do you realize that it wasn't God that named Eve? It was Adam that named Eve. And so, as a husband and a father, what you call your wife really matters. What you call your wife, it really, really matters. Why does it matter? It matters because it creates a particular self-esteem for her. If you look at her and say, "You, that fat woman," even when she is skinny, because you have called her fat, she will always see herself fat. And so what you call your woman is extremely important, man. That is why a man who is verbally abusive is not a real man. Real men doesn't abuse their wives verbally. Because anytime you speak in an insolent or disrespectful manner to your wife, your spouse, you break her self-esteem and you also break her spirit. Every good Jack makes a good Jill. In other words, if you are a bad Jack, you are going to make a bad jail. Every good husband makes a good wife. If you are not a good husband and a good father, you cannot have a good wife. It is not possible for you not to obey, but yet you want to command. For you to command, you must first and foremost obey. You cannot expect submission from your wife when you yourself, you are not in the place of love. And so, what you call your wife matters. And I want women to understand that the way you are programmed to think is different from the way we men are programmed to think. Women are programmed for luxury. Men are programmed for responsibility and work. That is why before Eve came on the scene, guess what Adam was doing? Adam was working. He was taking care of the garden. And so to we men, what matters to us is work. That is why as a man, if the devil wants to destroy you and destroy your self-esteem and who you are, he attacks the work of your hand. That is why when you see men meet and they are having conversation, men will not talk about relationship. They will not talk about dating. They will be talking about work and how to make money. Because that is how men were created. Women were created in the place of relationship. That is why women understand all the intricacies of relationship and love and affection, whilst men are still trying to figure out what this is all about. When you see a man standing or sitting very quiet, what he is thinking about is not love and affection. What he is thinking about is work. What he's thinking about is how to make money. That is why, as a woman, don't marry a man because he is handsome. He's part of it. Don't marry him because he looks cute and he has a swag. Don't forget, the cuteness of the man and the swag will not put food on the table. And so, as a father, you are a provider. Because Adam provided for Eve. He wasn't just a provider, he was also a protector. Men, listen to me. Good women never marry for money, but they marry where the money is. You don't understand. Good women never marry for money, but they marry where the money is. And it is not their fault. The reason is because women are created for enjoyment, whilst men are created to work. That is why when you see men who are single and they are looking for women who will come and take care of them, they are not real men. Because as a real man, you are supposed to be providing for your spouse. As a real father, you are supposed to be providing for your family, not the other way around. Anytime the woman begins to take care of the man, spiritual protocol is being broken. I have said this before, that what brought sin into this world, it is not necessarily Eve eating the forbidden fruit. Because Eve ate the forbidden fruit, the heavens was quiet. Heaven never responded. God never showed up. But when Eve gave the forbidden fruit to Adam, she broke spiritual protocol, because Eve is not supposed to be giving to Adam. Adam is supposed to be giving to Eve, because women are created to receive, whilst men are created to give. That is why men produce seed, but women are carriers of seed. And so when Eve gave Adam the forbidden fruit, spiritual protocol was broken, and that was how sin came into the world. And immediately God showed up and he said, Adam, where are thou? Do you realize that when God showed up, God didn't say, Eve, where are thou? He said, Adam, where are thou? Thou. In other words, what God was saying, Adam, what happened? Why did you make this happen? When you know the protocol, when you know that it is your responsibility to be given to your woman, and not the woman's responsibility to be given to you. What happened? What happened? What really happened? This was how sin came into the world. That is why a man, it doesn't matter, true men, real men, it doesn't matter how broke they are, they find it very difficult to take anything from their spouse, because that makes them feel less of a man. And every man is egoistic. We like to be respected. We like to be honored. We don't like to be undermined. We don't like to be devalued. And we don't like to be disrespected. Every man. And so as a man, you are a provider. As a father, you are a provider. Father simply means source. 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 Somebody say source. Now, if father means source, it means that everything that the woman will ever have must come from the man. Until a man releases a seed, a woman cannot conceive. The man is the source of provision in the house. The man is the source of security and protection in the house. The amazing thing about the incident that happened in the Garden of Eden is that after they have eaten the forbidden fruit and God has expelled them out of the garden, I expected Adam to say, "You Eve, you have made me lose my inheritance and my enjoyment. You have brought me to the place of hardship, difficulty, and penury." But Adam never said any of those things. He was stuck to his wife. He continued to love her through the thin and the thick. Real men don't run from their family when things are difficult. Real men don't abandon their family when things are hard. Real men bring the family together when things are tough. It is about time that we men, we got to be real men. We must take the responsibility as headship in our family and in our society. Today, if you look at our world, it looks like the women are taking the headship position and the men are nowhere to be found, because we have relegated our responsibility as men to the background. That is why today in the homes, the women are the head of the home. The women are the one who lifts up the family in prayer. When the men are supposed, as headship, be lifting up the family in prayer, and the wife and the children following, it is not like that. If the woman doesn't pray, there is trouble in the house. There is satanic invasion in the house. But real men praise. Real men, they don't just pray, they pray for their family, for the stability of their family, for the peace of their family, for the tranquility within the walls and the borders of their family. Real men will rise up and they will wake their spouse up.
They will wake their children up and they will open the scriptures and they will begin to expound the scriptures to their wife and their children. And after they finish, they will hold hands together and pray. As men, we are role models. That is why the scripture we read, it says that when we walk in our integrity, when we walk in our integrity, the Lord doesn't only bless us and bless our children, but he blesses them and they also follow after us. There was something that my twin sister said to me when my dad passed away. That thing will never leave me. Never ever leave me as long as I live. My dad passed away, it has been 11 years. I will never forget. They told me something, and it wasn't even part of the conversation, out of the blue. It's like they had a conversation and they decided to tell me. And this is what they said. They said, "Brother, we will never marry any man that is not like that. We will never marry any man that is not like that." That thing spoke volumes to me. It means that whilst my dad or our dad was alive, they were watching him. The way he handled my mother, the way he handled us, the integrity, the honesty, the trustworthiness, our upbringing, it created a lot of impact on their lives. One day, I was talking to the same twin sisters of mine, and they said something also to me. They said, "We never saw dad and ma divorce, so divorce shouldn't be in our vocabulary." Why am I giving you all these examples? I am giving you all these examples to tell you that as a father, you are a role model to your children. They are learning after, not before, not beside. They are learning after you. What you do, what you say, your reaction, your mannerism, and how you treat your wife at the house, they are watching because they have no other example beside yours. And if they are boys, when they grow up, they will treat their family just as they saw you treat them and treat their mother. You are a role model. And if you are a role model to your children, to your family, you must live by an example. Live by an example. Don't just tell them, do this, do that. Let them see you doing it. That is how children follow. Let them see you do it. Keep to your word when you promise them. Don't say anything to them that you will not honor. Because you are planting a seed of dishonesty in them. It is not easy to be a father. Why? Because when you look at the book of Ephesians, when Paul began to talk about marriage, this is the only thing he said as it relates to women. He said, women, wives, submit to your husband. Submit to your husband. In other words, submit to some few instructions. And the reason why also God said women should submit, because it is hard for women to submit. Women have a problem of submission. That is why it is said, a dumb man and a blind woman will have a happy marriage. A dumb man and a blind woman will have a happy marriage. You know why? If the man will not talk about every behavior of the woman and will keep quiet, and a woman who will not look at everything, because sometimes we men, we are so annoying. Annoying in the sense that we can be watching TV and the child is crying and the woman is at the kitchen cooking, and we will not take care of the child. Meanwhile, the child is close to us, beside us. We are waiting for the woman to get out of the kitchen, not just get out, to hear the sound of the crying, to get out of the kitchen, to come and take care of the child. And sometimes it makes women, I didn't say it, they said it. So if the woman will not see all these things, happiness will prevail in the house. Now back to why being a father is difficult. So Paul said, women, why submit? Then when it came to men, this is how he started. Men, love your wife as yourself. Number one. Husband, love your wives, even as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for it. That is what kills me. You really don't understand. I will repeat it again. Husband, love your wives, even as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for it. Now, Christ loved the church in spite of the blemishness of the church. Christ loved the church unconditionally. Which means that you as a real man, it doesn't matter the mistakes and the faults of the woman, you must still love her. It didn't end there. Project the scripture again. The dangerous one. Husband, love your wives even as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for it. Do you understand? Gave himself for it. Christ loved the church so much that he died for the church. And so what Paul was telling us men is that don't just love your woman as yourself, but be willing to die for her. It is not easy to be a father and to be a man. Do you realize that the Bible is saying that in spite of the mistakes, in spite of the faults, in spite of the sharp tongue, still love. Still love. even to the point of death. And women are just supposed to submit to some few instructions. And that's it. Even that one, you have a problem with that. Let me talk about men today. Let me not jump on you. And so it is not easy to be a man. It's not easy. And please, when we give you our hearts, handle it with care. Because listen to me, it is hard for a man to truly fall in love. And when a man is truly in love, he gives his in and all. That is why most men will tell you, I love you, but I'm telling you, it's a lie. Because men lies more than women. Hey, listen, you don't understand. Let me finish before you start clapping. Now, when I say men lie more than women, this is the reason why. It doesn't mean that women don't lie. In fact, women lie a lot. Actually, more than men. No, listen, are you with me? Can I work this thing? The reason why men are seen as liars, because scientifically it is proven that men think with one side of their brain. And so a man will lie, and when you ask, he forgets what he has said. But scientifically it is proven that women think with the two sides of their brain. And so they can lie. When you ask them 10 years, they will repeat. They will repeat the same thing. That doesn't make them truthful. It's just that they recollect the lie that they spoke. So I've come to a conclusion. Women lie more than men. Hallelujah. Amen. And so you must understand that when a man gives his heart to you, you must take care of that heart. Don't break it and don't take it for granted. Real men don't like their women taking them for granted. Real men want to be in charge. That is why anytime a woman tries to control the husband, there is going to be chaos. There is going to be problem. And when you look at that woman, when you look under her eyes, you will see that there is some sort of witchcraft. Because it is only witchcraft that will make you want to control your husband. Because scripture doesn't approve of that. Do you know what submission is? When the Bible says submit, it means that you, the woman, before you met the man, you had a mission. But immediately you come together, your mission must submit. Must come under his mission. That is what submission means. Submission is not subjection. Submission is for you to come under, not over. So when you try to come over, and because we men and fathers, we are created in a place of authority and power. When you try to overtake us and come on top of us and exploit us and control and manipulate us, we will be strongly defiant. And believe you me, If God is not on your side, the love would disappear within a twinkle of an eye. Because men always want to be in charge. The role of a father is to be in control, making sure that his house is in order. Real men respect their wives. Respect their wives. I don't know how you became a man when you don't respect your woman. I don't know how you are a real man when you talk anyhow to your woman. Don't forget, the children are watching. They are watching. They are watching. The way you handle mommy. They are watching. The way you talk to mommy. They are watching. And they will emulate after you what they see. Real man. A real man shouldn't have a faint heart. It is said that a faint heart never wins a beautiful woman. When your heart is faint, you can never win your wife. It means that you got to be tough. Have you ever heard most of the conversation of single women, and one of their criteria, I want to marry a strong man. A strong man. Not a fainted-hearted man. A strong man. A strong man. The Bible says that when you fail in the time of adversity, when you fail in the time of adversity as a man, it means that you are weak and you have a faint heart. Women are looking for strong women, strong men. And you know why strong men? The reason why women are looking for strong men, strong fathers, is because they are looking for men who will give direction. Direction at home. Men that will create the blueprint for the family. Today, look at the church. How many men are in the church? And look at the women. When we are supposed to be taking the family to church, we sit down at home and say, oh, when you go to church, pray for me. Pray for me. You see, that my contract, that my job. Don't forget. Pray for me. When you are supposed to be leading the family in prayer, you are telling her to pray for you. No direction. No direction. Even saying that means that you are not leading. You are not leading. Real men lead. They go ahead whilst the family follows. Real men. Real men spend time, quality time, with their family. There should be a time that as a man and as a father, turn your phone off. Go to a place with your family when it is just you and your family. The Bible talks about the man nourishing the wife, the husband nourishing the wife. How do you nourish if you don't spend time? How do you bring the best out of her if you don't spend time with her? How do you raise sons and daughters of integrity when you don't spend time with them to pour out and to download your wisdom into them. Even though we as men and as fathers, we were created in a place of responsibility and work, but don't let your work and your responsibility overshadow and overtake your family responsibility. Spending time with your family. Spending time, quality time with your family. Because anytime you are not at home, and anytime you relegate your family to the background, what they begin to think is this: whatever daddy is doing is more important than us. That is why today you see the youth looking for affection, love, acceptance in the wrong places. Because the fathers are not there. They are not there. They are nowhere to be found. They are not home. And so a boy grows up and the boy doesn't know what to do to be a real man, because daddy wasn't at home and daddy never spent any time with him. And so they try to fit in. What they see, what their friends are doing. That is why there are so many that have been incarcerated. Because fathers weren't home. It's about time that we as fathers, we must stay home and nurture our kids. Talk to them about responsibility. Talk to them about integrity. Talk to them about hard work. Talk to them about adversities of life. How is part of human life? It is said that a man is a measure of all things. And if a man is a measure of all things, then we must live up to it. Let's live up to it. Let us live up to it. Let us live a life of decency. Because people are watching. We are role models. We are role models. We are role models. That is why if you build a strong relationship with your family, all these things that oftentimes, I'm not saying that it should be in the excess, but all these things that parents most of the time doesn't want the children to see and to know how much they feel about each other is wrong. Learn to kiss your spouse in the presence of your children. You are planting the seed of affection in them, love in them. You are teaching them how to love. Say some great things to your wife in the presence of your children. Real men will go to the kitchen and help their wives. I may not know how to cook, but I want to cut the onions. I may not know how to cook, but I want to cut the tomato. I may not know how to cook, but I want to wash the dishes whilst you are cooking. I want to clean whilst you are cooking. That is what real men do. Go in there, go to the kitchen there and just help. Give a helping hand. Have sweet talks with your wife, with your spouse. Let the children see. We are role models. People are looking. The children are looking. They are watching. Oftentimes, we as men, we think that being a real man is sitting down and being bossy. Don't go there. Go here. Do this. Don't do that. I told you not to wear this. You have worn it. You don't respect. Don't you fear. You are not a real man. A real man. Your children even cannot talk to you because they are afraid. Your children cannot relate to you because they don't know how you are going to react. And so they have some things that are in their heart that they want to share with you, but because they don't know how you are going to react and you have not cultivated that intimacy and relationship with them, they go out and be talking to the wrong people and they get the wrong counsel and then they become bad children. Stop being bossy and be a real man. Let me tell you, when you are a real man, you don't need to be bossy, but everything around you will be in alignment. When you are a king, you don't need anybody to come and make your wife a queen. She is an automatic queen. Be a king. Let your wife be a queen. But if you are not the king, your wife cannot be the queen that you want her to be, which means that you must lead in the right direction for her to follow. You see, when you are leading as a man and as a father in the right direction, and you are doing what you are supposed to do as a father and a man, the women don't struggle submitting. It is very easy for them to submit. Very easy. Very easy for them to submit. And whatever you want, you get. You get it. There is a problem about a lot of men. Because women are moved by what they hear and men are moved by what they see, men, be very careful what you watch. Real men will not be walking with their spouses and see other ladies and be doing this. And they're like, what are you watching? Real men don't do that. Real men don't do that. What are you looking at? What are you beholding that is not already by your side? What are you looking for that you don't already have? What you don't see, your heart cannot grieve about it. You don't understand. What you don't see, your heart cannot grieve about it. Real men don't look at any other woman beside their wives. They are women. It is only coward. Men who are coward, men who doesn't live up to expectation and doesn't take their roles as fathers, that will be working with their wives, with their spouses, with their women, and anything that is in skirt that passes by, they start salivating. What are you salivating about? What are you looking at? You are very fortunate that your toes didn't come off. Because the other time when you were watching, you saw how your toe hit that stone. Let men be men. Be real men. Let's stop behaving like boys. We are men. And we should be privileged to be men. The other day I told my wife, if I finish my assignment, I get to heaven and God said, I'm sending you back. Which sex do you want? I said, God, please make me a man. I love to be a man. Because I don't need to buy Brazilian hair. I don't need to do eyelashes. I don't need to do eyelashes and all that. I don't need to do all those kind of things. Hallelujah. I don't need to put nails and I don't need to be, go to the saloon every day and I don't need to do all that, I don't need to have all the dresses and the shoes in the world. Women, we really don't care. As long as you have three and you keep it clean and you can coordinate the colors, that is okay. I don't need every day to match. To match. Matching shoe. Matching bag. Right now, it is not just matching shoe and matching bag. It is matching facials. So your shoe is blue, bag blue, your face blue. Oh, I'm working this thing. I'm working it. So I love being a man. It's very simple. Very, very simple. Simple. And when you are a man, you don't spend too much money on yourself. I go to the barber shop, $15, I'm done. Simple. If I decide to give a tip, the highest, $20, I am done. But when you enter into a saloon as a woman, if you don't spend at all, and that day the favor, and the person knows you, and the person said, it is because of you, it's $100. So I love being a man. So let us be real men. Let us be real men. Let us be real men. Real men read the Bible. Real men pray. Real men live according to the word. Real men. Real men. Oftentimes people think that authority and power, to exhibit authority and power, is in shouting. It is not. It's not. It is not. Let me tell you something. In fact, when you shout and you are screaming, listen to me, you don't have power. You don't have authority. Those who possess real power and real authority. When my dad was alive, he never opens his mouth. When you look at his eyes and his face, you know exactly what he's saying. Exactly what he's saying. When he gets a visitor and you are around, he's not going to tell you in the presence of the visitor, go upstairs, go to your room. Just then, you yourself, you start marching. Nothing came out of his mouth, but he has spoken. It is not in the screaming. It is not in the shouting. Real men don't shout and scream to show power and authority and to prove that you are in charge. You see, the way you carry yourself will make everybody in the family respect you. You don't need to be screaming and shouting and jumping all over the place. and prove that you have a bad temper. You will make my temper come. My anger is coming. No. When you do that, you are making a fool out of yourself, and you are telling the people around you that you are not a man, you are a boy. Oh boy. You are a boy. Real men don't do all those things. Real men keep their composure even when they are angry. They keep their composure because they don't want to act out of character. Why? Because the children are watching. People are watching. Because the way they react, somebody is going to emulate it. Somebody is going to copy it. Somebody is going to duplicate it. And somebody is going to do exactly the same thing. Let us be real men. Let us be fathers. The fathers that God created us to be. Let us walk in integrity and honor. Let us walk in dignity. Let us fulfill our God-given purpose, assignment, and mandate. Real fathers, listen. Fathers may not talk much because we men, we are not created to be parrots. So most men don't talk. But as for women, women women can talk. Women can talk. And women will talk about everything. Everything. The one that matters and the one that doesn't matter. Women talk about everything. And let me tell you, women, the fact of the matter is that women, we are not interested. No, stay with me. Men are not interested in all this talking and all this talking and when you went to work, what happened? Who looked at your direction? Who gave you coffee? Who gave you water? And what did you eat? And what happened? Your boss. And what? That secretary. And that person. Oh, that your assistant. Oh, that your accountant. What did... When men come home, they want to just sit down and relax and think. You know why? Because we men, we are not emotional beings. We are rational beings. We like thinking. We are logical beings. Women are emotional beings. That is why women cry very easily than men. And when you see a man crying, then you know that what is happening is more than serious. It's seriously serious for you to see a man crying, because we are not created and wired to be emotional. Women are wired to be emotional. That is why women, they are wired. They are 90% emotional and 10% logical. Whilst men are 90% logical and 10% emotional. That is why when you come to church, you see the women dancing more, worshiping more, praising God more, and you will see the men standing and sitting trying to figure out all that is happening in the church and around them. That is why in church like this and in any church, you don't see men just come and get involved. They must survey. They must look. They must study. But women just flow like that. Hardly will you see a man prophesying, but you see women prophesying. they are able to discern. They are able to pick up in the spirit very easily. Like that. So men are not interested in all the talking. Now, even though we are not interested in all the talking, because you are a role model, because you are the head, you must make time to listen. Listen. Don't let them feel, the women or your children feel, like what they are saying doesn't matter to you. Listen. As a father, as a head, as a man, you must learn how to listen. Sometimes, as the women, you don't need to do any talking, but as far as she has your 100% attention, she's okay. Okay. As far as you are just standing there, and sometimes my wife will talk, and I will just stand there. When she finishes, okay, I've heard. Simple. And she is happy. Because everything she said, I stood there, listened, gave her undivided attention, and I concluded, I have heard. She is happy. Than her asking me, did you hear what I said? What did you say? Where were you? It means that something is getting your attention. Listen. Real men listens. Listen. You may not talk so much like your wife, but learn how to listen. God bless you and rise on your feet. Hallelujah. Amen. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. I want you, as a man, walk up to three women and tell them, I'm the real man. Tell them.
I'm a real man.
Hallelujah. Now, if you didn't say it to any woman, you are not sure if you are a real man. So let me give you another opportunity to tell two people, I'm the real man. Men, look at the women and tell them, I'm the real man. Amen. Now, before we worship a little bit and take offering, there is something that, you know, I just left out. It just came to my mind. If I don't say it, I don't think I finished my message. Real men don't beat their spouses. Real men. Real man. Now, give me 3 minutes. Let me talk about it. No, I'll not just say it like that. Sit down. 3 minutes. You may be seated. Because it just came into my spirit. And if it came into my spirit, God wants me to address it. Because there may be men here who are boxers. Hallelujah. Real men don't beat their spouses. Just imagine How can you beat your spouse when the Bible says loving her is like loving yourself? How can you just get up and start punching yourself? I love myself so much that I will not get up and be punching myself. Everybody loves himself or herself. And so if loving her is like loving yourself, then why are you beating her in the first place? Because beating her is like beating yourself. Real men don't punch their wives. Real men don't hit their wives. Real men don't do that. Unless you know you are not a real man. Because as a real man, if you hit or punch your spouse or your woman, how do you see yourself? The Bible says that we should handle the women with care because what? They are fragile. You hit her, you punch her, and still be with her. That is another definition of insanity. And it is another level of foolishness. Real men don't beat their spouses. Because if you're a real man, you don't need to hit her, kick her, slap her for her to listen to you. Real men just talk. Real men just speak. And their wives, their spouses, obliged. Their women, obliged. If you're a real man and you want to fight, get your fellow man. The only reason why you are fighting your spouse is because you are not a real man. You are not strong. You are weak. Oh, weak. You are very weak. Shame on you. You are a disgrace to manhood. If you want to fight, go to the ring. Meet your fellow man. If it is fight you want, meet your fellow man who will beat you very well. Don't unleash your anger on your wife. Real men don't hit their spouse. Rise on your feet. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Again, I want to wish all the men happy, happy, happy Father's Day. Amen.
Amen.
We are the best. We are the greatest. And if not for us, the women wouldn't be here. It is because of us. That's why the women are around. If the women don't clap for us, we will extinguish all the women on the earth. It is because of us, that is why there are women around. If Adam hadn't have said, I'm alone, women will remain in eternity. So it's because of us, that is why you are around. Amen. So women, clap for all the fathers.
Thank you for watching this message. For more information about this message or the ministry, call us at 770-941-1934 or visit us online at eagleschapel.com.